Welcome back to GN Sports, brought to you by Blue Cross Blue Shield. Time for a live Gimme 5. And joining us tonight in studio, former Bear Jerry Azumah. Check out his new podcast, To the Point, wherever you get your podcast. I was just on it. So thank you, Zoom, for stopping by.
Thanks
tonight.
For having me. Thanks Yo. For having me.
You know everybody's waiting for this conversation.
We have a lot on our chest.
We got a lot on our chest, and we don't got a lot of time. So I got to ask you, looking at this team now, and we were just talking about it, 0-2, with all the new additions that they had on this roster, did you expect them to be this far behind early in the season?
I don't think anyone expected that. You know what I'm saying? I mean, there's been a lot of talks about rebuilding this team, and they've really stripped it down, just stripped it totally apart. And then put some good pieces together. It felt good. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? And then against Green Bay, I don't know what happened, but they just look so unprepared. And it's really unfortunate because everyone wants this team to be successful. Everyone wants them to be good. We've been waiting a long time for the Chicago Bears to have some success, and they did not get off to a good start at all.
2 weeks into this season, there's a lot of different places you can put blame because it's not just one unit or one coach or one player that's kind of derailing things right now for this team. But we have to start with Justin Fields because when you're the quarterback of this team, that's where a lot of the finger pointing goes to. And it's not like he's necessarily taken steps back from what we saw last season, but 2 weeks into the season, specifically against Tampa Bay, there were several instances where it just felt like he was maybe holding on the ball too long, wasn't getting through all of his reads. Is this a Justin Fields thing, or is this a play calling scheme not playing to his skill set?
I think it's a little bit of both. You know what I'm saying? It's up to the coaches to prepare the players to get ready for football games. And one, he just didn't really look prepared. And then number two, he got in there and he was hesitant. It seemed like he was almost scared to make a play, go out there and make a play, or basically just scared to make mistakes. He has to just let it go. You know what I'm saying? If the read isn't there, one or number two, take off. That's what he did really good last year. And he was very successful at that, rushed for over 1,000 yards. So they have to try to find some type of a rhythm. They have to get all the guys on the team involved. DJ Moore, throw the ball to him more. He has Moore in his last name. Throw the ball to him more. And then hit the tight end also. I think the tight end could be a strong asset for Justin Fields. He's a big body, and Cole Kmet can run as well. So they have to be able to get the ball. He has to get the ball off in time, and then the guys just have to go out there and make some plays.
That last play right there, that was the seam route that he should have thrown. And every time that I see it, it gets me because watch right here. Yeah. I want to plant that foot and fire that ball right now. It's got to be gone.
There's guys that are open, and he's missing them. He's hesitant.
He's hesitant to fire it in there, but then there are certain times where you look at these times, and we're talking about 4.4 seconds, 5 seconds. That's not a lot of time. Like that, it's really quick. It's a blink of an eye when we're talking about in the NFL in a pass rush. Mm-hmm. How much do you think it's kind of some of this stuff has been it's scar tissue from over the last 2 years of being sacked so many times that his internal clock is going a little bit too fast that he can't slow down the game, which we know the best quarterbacks in the league, that's what they're able to do.
True, but he also has the outlet of his athleticism as well.
True.
And he's able to get out of bad situations that he might not put himself into. You know, he was sacked 6 times. And out of those 6 times, it's almost like half of those times he kind of fell into the sack because he was hesitant. He just has to just relax and just trust his guys that they're going to be where they have to be. Deliver the ball, and if it's not there, take off and run because that's where he's really good at.
Yes.
We have to talk about this defense, especially with you, Jerry.
Goodness.
Because Matt Eberflus called the defense because of the absence of Allen Williams. And Jack Sanborn said today he felt like they were more aggressive. Well, the stats would say otherwise. And when you look at what the defense wasn't able to do, Bucks 8 of 15 on third down. Ugh. The fact that the Buccaneers had 437 total yards of offense against this Bears defense.
Baker.
One quarterback hit on Baker Mayfield.
Baker.
Jerry, help us out here. Where do you start when you're talking about this defense and some of the liabilities now?
At the very beginning of the season, I thought that the defense was going to be strong. They made a lot of additions, especially at linebacker. Our secondary seemed to be, you know, really good. You had E-Jack back there, and you know what he can bring to the table. But I don't know what is going on with the defense. Like, they're not getting a push up front, and it all starts in the trenches, as we all know. You got to push that line of scrimmage and reestablish that line of scrimmage up front. They're not doing that. They're not winning their one-on-one battles. They're not doing that. They're not covering the running backs out of the backfield or the tight ends because they've been wide open for the last two games. There's holes and breakdowns all over the place. I know that they're a little injured and they're struggling with that, but there's guys that got to come in and fill in and just play solid. And they're just not doing that right now.
That third and 14, Mayfield to Evans, that one was the real.
That was a tough one. Yeah. I mean, I'm watching Baker Mayfield looking like he all
Oklahoma.
Pro.
Like he's at Oklahoma again.
Like Heisman Trophy.
It's amazing.
And that's what gets me. So if we're going to talk about Matt Eberflus calling this defense, and listen, when it comes down to it, the whole entire operation, he's the CEO, he's the one controlling everything. When you look at this, Jerry, moving forward, if you're going into KC week three, Patrick Mahomes already's got like 28, 30 points on the board already before you get off the bus. What? I got a question. They go 0-3. That heat start heating up on under his seat a little bit, or is it too early because this team is going to grow as the season goes on?
I would like to believe that this team will grow as the season goes on. They're off to a horrible start. You know what I'm saying? Baker Mayfield, he had a career day, basically over 400 and something, you know, total yards. And now we're going to the defending Super Bowl champions home with Mahomes. And they're full power, too. They have Kelsey, who's healthy. They have Chris Jones in the middle. So they're at full firepower right now. So I don't really know what is going to happen for next week, but I'll tell you what, Kansas City is going to be prepared. It's up for the coaching staff to really buckle down and prepare this team to go into Kansas City and just be efficient, effective, be creative, because I feel like they've lacked a lot of that, especially on the offensive side of the ball.
Sharky, I'm going to let you get the last question. I got to ask a DB this question, because you were talking about the importance of a pass rush.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Tell me how tough it is for a guy like you playing outside if you don't have a pass rush.
Well, I mean, it just becomes routes on air. I mean, if you have an NFL quarterback that's back there just patting the ball, then he's going to complete the pass. That's just what it is. You have to have a pass rush. You have to establish that line of scrimmage up front. And if there's none of that, then the guys behind you, it's going to be a long day for them.
And they're dealing with a number of injuries, too, and that's only going to make it harder for the Bears. And when you talk about going into – you never want to be in this position, but when you're going into week three and you have to go down to Arrowhead and face Patrick Mahomes and the Chiefs, how do you avoid – I know it seems silly to say losing a locker room this early in the season, but you're looking back now at a 12-game losing streak. And I know there's some new faces, but a lot of those guys went through the 12-game losing streak and have been there. How do you avoid – just everything falling apart when you're facing an opponent that you know, like JP said, could have 20 points on the board by the time you get off the plane?
You have to try to establish some type of a rhythm. That's number one. And I think that the running backs are running hard. Herbert and Roshan, they are running hard. And they're running with a chip on their shoulder. I think that you have to basically feed them early and often. Get them involved in the game plan. And get the ball out of Justin Fields' hand. And what I mean by that is short, quick passes, quick throws, three-step, you know what I'm saying? Get the ball out, rhythm time passes, and then just continue to pound them on the run. And I think that would be pretty much the road to success, or somewhat success. But Fields also, he's a good runner of the football as well. Exactly, but like I said, he's hesitant. And he needs to stop being hesitant. He needs to just go out there. He knows how to play football. He knows what he can do because we saw it last season. He needs to just go out there and just do it.
We gotta go. I got so much to talk about. Zoom,
there's a lot on your chest. I understand.
I was probably gonna get myself in trouble. Zoom, appreciate you for coming
tonight,
man. All right, we gotta take a break.